وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على عبد الله ورسوله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to another installment of Ramadan Daily Droplets, where we bring you a benefit relating to the month of Ramadan every single day. Something different to think about and reflect upon, and something that relates to the month of Ramadan and is connected to the month of Ramadan. What I would like to talk to you about today, inshallah ta'ala, is Ramadan as a month of change. A month to change yourself. And changing yourself and making an effort to make a change is a huge, huge part of Islam and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to do. Remember, Ramadan is the month where we are trying to develop a taqwa. We're trying to develop an ability to be more obedient to Allah and less disobedient to Allah. Allah Azza wa Jal told us, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامِ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ O you who believe, fasting has been made obligatory for you, as it was obligatory for those who came before you, so that you might become from a people of taqwa. So we're trying to develop that nearness to Allah Azza wa Jal. But if we look at where we're starting from, and where we're aiming for, we see the need for change. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Qur'an that change has to come from us. Allah Azza wa Jal told us in Surah Al-Ra'd, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ Allah will not change a people or what is with a people until they change what is with themselves. So Allah commanded us to change ourselves, and then Allah Azza wa Jal will facilitate a change in our situation. And when you think about it, we don't control the situation that we're in, and we don't control the tawfiq of Allah, and we don't control how things are going to end up for us, the aqibah, the eventual outcome. None of that is in our hands. What Allah has given us is a limited ability to make that effort and to work hard to make a change within ourselves. And when we do that, Allah promises us that it's not until we do that that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will facilitate for us for our situation to change. And this can be on all different levels. And it can relate because the word إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ The word ma here is min alfaz al-umum. It's from the general words that covers everything. So whether it is a person being in a state of blessings, being in a state of ease, Allah will not change that until they do something which causes that to change. For example, they commit a sin or they do something which distances them from Allah. The other way is true as well. Someone in a state of disobedience, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not bring them to happiness and will not improve their situation until they strive and they make that effort to make that change for themselves. And likewise, on an individual level and on a wider level, people talk about when is the situation of this ummah going to change? Situation of the Muslims going to change? إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ Allah will not change anything about the situation of a people until they make that effort to change what is in, or until they themselves cause that change, either, as we said, if it's a situation of sin, by making that effort to turn towards the obedience of Allah. And again, link that to the month of Ramadan, which is the month of at-taqwa, the month where we are trying to develop additional obedience to Allah Azza wa Jal and distance ourselves from disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why Imam al-Sa'di said about this ayah in Surah Al-Ra'd, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ Imam al-Sa'di rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, وَكَذَلِكَ إِذَا غَيَّرَ الْعِبَادُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ مِنَ الْمَعْصِيَةِ فَانْتَقَلُوا إِلَى طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ غَيَّرَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مَا كَانُوا فِيهِ مِنَ الشَّقَاءِ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَالسُّرُورِ وَالْغِبْطَةِ وَالرَّحْمَةِ He said, if the servants, this way or similarly, if the servant changes what is with them from disobedience and changes the disobedience that they're doing and starts to obey Allah and moves towards, فَانْتَقَلُوا, moves towards obeying Allah, Allah will change the wretchedness that is within them. And that الشَّقَى, it could be that the person is شَقِيٌ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ نَسَى اللَّهَ الْعَفْوَ وَالْعَافِيَةِ. A person could be in a state of wretchedness in this dunya. وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ. Whoever turns away from my remembrance will have a hard, rough life, a difficult life, a depressed life. Because even if the outer self might be in a state of having things and a state of, you know, relative ease in the dunya, but the heart of that person that turns away from the remembrance of Allah is shaqi, is wretched, and it's sad and depressed. And worse than that is the wretchedness in the hereafter. But Allah Azza wa Jal promised to change that situation of a person if they make that effort to change themselves. What an opportunity it is to change from that wretchedness to al-khayr, to goodness, and al-surur, and happiness, and al-ghibta, bliss, and al-rahmah, mercy. If we want that for ourselves, we need to make that change. And the beautiful thing about the month of Ramadan is that the month of Ramadan has all of the elements needed within it to facilitate that change and make it easy for us. The fact that the doors of Jannah open, the fact the doors of Jahannam are closed, the fact that the shayateen are locked up, the fact that it is said to the people, or to, it's said, Ya baghi al khayri aqbil, wa ya baghi al sharri aqsir. It is said, O doer of good, come forward. O doer of evil, desist. There are so many opportunities this Ramadan to change yourself. Everything is here to be able to make that change. And that links it back to what we said about the ayah, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, in the hope that you become from the people of taqwa. Everything is there within Ramadan. The ingredients are there in Ramadan to facilitate for you to be able to make that change. And it's a once in a year, and who knows, perhaps it might be a once in a lifetime, because none of us know how long we're going to live or what situation we'll be in next year. But it is the once in a year opportunity for you to make those changes that you wanted to make. And just to highlight this, there's a really beautiful statement that was made by one of the writers, one of the people who wrote, famous for al-adab, you know, writing and poetry and things like that. One of the famous authors or the famous writers, he wrote, Ramadan ma huwa illa fatra raha wa hudu. He said, Ramadan is a fatra. Fatrat raha wa hudu. It's a time of raha, a time of hudu, a time where it's tranquil, and a time where things become a little more relaxed and slowed down. But perhaps he means by this from the matters of this world, in terms of the worldly life and the distractions, and the distractions of the shayateen. Things settle down and become a little more calm. Salamun hiya hatta matla' al-fajr, as it said about Laylatul Qadr, the tranquility that is found within it. And then he said, Ya'buru al-mu'minu min khilaliha ila maraqi al-su'ud fi darajat al-iman. He said, the believer within this month climbs the levels of ascendancy in the levels of their iman. They ascend through the levels of iman. They ascend through the levels of al-iman. And then he said, and this is what I wanted to highlight, and it's really very beautiful what he said. فَمَنِ اسْتَفَادَ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْفَتْرَةِ فِي إِصْلَاحِ حَالِهِ وَتَجْدِيدِ إِيمَانِهِ وَمُرَاجَعَةِ نَفْسِهِ فَقَدْ وَجَدَ لِلتَّغْيِيرِ طَرِيقًا. He said, whoever benefits from this time in correcting their situation, renewing their iman. Remember, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, "Inna al-imana la yakhlaqu fi jawfi ahadikum kama yakhlaqu al-thawb, fas'alu Allah ta'ala an yujaddid al-imana fi qulubikum," aw kama qala sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, "Your iman wears out like your thawb wears out. So ask Allah the exalted to renew the iman that is in your hearts. So whoever takes this Ramadan as a chance to correct their situation and to renew their iman and to look at themselves and go back to themselves and really look at what is there and what needs to change, this person has found a means, a road, a pathway to change. And that's because, and he highlighted some of the things that are essential for change to happen, positive change. And he mentioned that positive change requires three things. And he said, كُلُّهَا مُتَوَافِرَةً وَمُهَيِّئَ لِلْعَبْدِ فِي هَذَا الشَّهْرِ الْكَرِيمِ. He said, all of these things are in abundance and they're made available for the servant in this month of Ramadan. If you look at anyone who writes, writer and author, anyone who writes about, you know, people talk about positivity and how to make changes and what you need to change, you'll find all the elements of positive change exist within the month of Ramadan. The month of Ramadan, first of all, you have a chance to make muraja'a of yourself. مُرَاجَعَةُ الْعَبْدِ ذَاتَهُ وَتَقْيِيمَهُ لِنَفْسِهِ وَتَقْيِيمُهُ لِنَفْسِهِ وَتَشْخِيصُ أَمْرَاضِهِ. You have a chance to go back to yourself. You have a chance to evaluate yourself. And you have a chance to examine the sicknesses that are there within the heart. SubhanAllah. Allah Azza wa Jal told us, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَالْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدْ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Or you who believe, have taqwa of Allah and let everyone look at what He's put forward for tomorrow. This ayah is an asl, it is a fundamental text as it relates to correcting yourself and taking yourself to account. مُحَاسَبَةُ النَّفْسِ مُرَاجَعَةُ النَّفْسِ. Taking yourself to account, looking at yourself. The author here, he used the expression taqyeem. You measure yourself, you evaluate yourself and ask yourself, where am I at right now? And you examine the sicknesses in the heart like the doctor would examine the sicknesses in the body. You would come to the doctor and say, I have a pain in my chest. The doctor examines your chest and he says, you have this and you have this. You examine your heart. You make tashkhis of your heart. You examine it and you find the sicknesses that are within it and you prescribe the cure as it is prescribed for you in the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. This is one of the essential things to make a positive change. And this is available to you in the month of Ramadan. Muslims generally all over the world, we find it easier in Ramadan. The reduced influence of the shaitan, the opportunities for worship, the time that you spend alone, whether it be itikaf or whether it be the time that you spend in worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, extra time praying and so on, you find it easier to examine yourself and to become aware of some of the sicknesses that are there. Secondly, you have a chance to put in place a plan to change. Ramadan is a wonderful time for this, for you to actually sit and say, okay, we're not here to be Muslims just for Ramadan. We want to do something more after that. So let me put a plan in place. I'm going to start now. I'm not going to start tomorrow. Let me put a plan in place, a plan to change myself and what I'm going to do and the steps that I am going to take. And then you have a chance for al-him wal-azima nahwa al-afdal. You have a chance for you to have determination and aspirations and motivation towards what is better. For we've spoken how Ramadan is a month of motivation. That's already something that we have spoken about in the Daily Droplet series. So that motivation is there. The things are there to motivate you to be better. The opportunities for forgiveness, the opportunities that exist in Ramadan are there to motivate you to be better. So you find the motivation and you find the azima, the determination to do this. But you also need to realize that these things can only be achieved with the help of Allah Azza wa Jal, by submitting to Him, by making dua to Him. Because these are the things that are going to support you in what is going to help you to make a change. And in this, it reminds me of the hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And the part of the hadith al-shahid that I wanted to share with you that kind of reminds me about this is the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ihris عَلَى مَا يَنْفَعُكَ وَاسْتَعِمْ بِاللَّهِ وَلَا تَعْجِزِ. That be keen for what will benefit you, and seek the help of Allah, and don't feel that you have been defeated or that you're ajiz, you're unable to do it. So you have every opportunity in this month to change. And I want to conclude with a statement of the great Imam Ibn Qudamah, rahimahullah ta'ala. He said, وَلِلصَّوْمِ ثَلَاثُ مَرَاتِبُ صَوْمُ الْعُمُومِ وَصَوْمُ الْخُصُوصِ وَصَوْمُ خُصُوصِ الْخُصُوصِ. He said, fasting has three levels. There's a general fast, there's a special fast, and there's a special, special fast. So what are these three levels of fasting that Ibn Qudamah told us about? He said, فَأَمَّا صَوْمُ الْعُمُومِ فَهُوَ كَفُّ الْبَطَنِ وَالْفَرْجِ عَنْ قَضَاءِ الشَّهْوَةِ. He said, as for the general fasting, it's to stop your stomach, your private parts from fulfilling their desires. That's the fast of Ramadan, right? To refrain from food and drink and the other things which break the fast. That's the fast of Ramadan. This is what he calls صَوْمُ الْعُمُومِ, the general fast. وَأَمَّا صَوْمُ الْخُصُوصِ, as for the special fast, فَهُوَ كَفُّ النَّظَرِ وَاللِّسَانِ وَالْيَدْ وَالرِّجْلِ وَالسَّمْعِ وَالْبَصَرِ وَسَائِرَ الْجَوَارِحِ عَنِ الْأَثَامِ. It is to stop you looking and to stop your eyesight, your talking, your hands, your feet, your hearing, your sight, all of your limbs from doing sins. And ultimately that's a little bit more, right? That's more than just the minimum to get your fast accepted. I'm just going to not eat and I'm not going to drink. It's a bit more than that now. Now I'm going to try to keep my limbs away from the haram in every single way. So if that's the special fast, what's the special fast? So Ibn Qudamah rahimahullah ta'ala, he told us about the special fast. He said, وَأَمَّا صَوْمُ خُصُوصِ الْخُصُوصِ فَهُوَ صَوْمُ الْقَلْبِ عَنِ الْهِمَمِ الدَّنِيئَةِ وَالْأَفْكَارِ الْمُبْعِدَةِ عَنِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى وَكَفُّهُ عَمَّا سِوَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى بِالْكُلِّيَّةِ. He said, as for the special fast, it is for the heart to fast from all of those low and lowly motivations and desires and the thoughts which take you away from Allah, and to make the heart completely disconnected from anything except Allah in a complete sense, completely, bil kulliya, in a complete way. That's what the special fast is. And that shows you how Ramadan trains you to change. Because if you look at these three levels, you start off just leaving food and drink. And then you're leaving sins to the greatest extent that you can. And finally, you reach a level where your heart becomes disconnected from everything except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that shows you what an opportunity you have this Ramadan to make a real and lasting change. And we're going to conclude by asking Allah Azza wa Jal, Al-Hayy Al-Qayyum, who is the ever-living, the sustainer of all creation, Dhul Jalali Wal-Ikram, the one who is the Dhul Jalali Wal-Ikram, the owner of majesty and honor. We're going to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us all from the people who make positive changes this Ramadan, and from the people who make lasting changes that are sincere for the sake of Allah and that are in accordance with the sunnah of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah azza wa jal give you and I the tawfiq to be among the people who change what is with themselves for that which is better. And that is what Allah has made easy for me to mention, and Allah knows best. Wassalatu wassalam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.